Welcome to Stitch Along Fridays.
Yes. Yeah. Good morning.
Do you know that I still think of it as Facebook Friday, but I'm trying really hard not to.
to say something else than Facebook Friday?
Exactly.
Stitch Along Friday is good.
A whole bunch of things that come new, right?
That's right. It's like, what the heck? We've never seen that before.
Hello, Wanda. How are you?
Hi, Wanda.
It's actually, today, it's, okay, ready?
Yes, you go ahead. I can't say it.
Kong Chi Fa Chai.
Yeah.
That's good, right? That's Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
In Chinese. I think it means
good health.
Good fortune.
Good fortune.
Yes. It has more to do with that you do well in economic times.
Exactly. And let's hope that is true for all
exactly.
of us.
Exactly.
Yes.
And then, of course, it's almost Valentine's Day.
Yes.
It's pretty exciting, actually. We've got our red on for both of those occasions because very lucky to have red around you.
Exactly. Mine looks really dark here, but it actually is red if I take my sweater off. It's just really chilly today, so I'm not taking my sweater
off. Isn't it the truth?
Yeah.
Did you know this fact, this little known fact, that all across Canada we have minus temperatures?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
in
okay.
every single province and every single city, even Victoria.
And that normally does not happen. We normally don't see minus temperatures.
So we're joining the rest of the North America, and we've got some snow coming.
We do.
Tonight. Midnight.
Yes. And it's supposed to snow all day tomorrow, so I can sit at home and not, stay in my PJs and...
We're going to be snowed in, aren't we?
That's right. Exactly.
Pretty exciting.
That's what I was planning.
And actually, it's all going to go away because on Monday it's going to rain.
Yeah.
Which is our holiday because we have a long weekend this
weekend. That's right. Exactly.
So you've got the whole weekend to just be snowed in.
Snowed in. I'm looking forward to it. I've got things planned on my sewing table already. So...
Have you got your TV movie lineup also? Because that's part of the whole thing, right?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I can always find something to watch.
Or radio. I just found a link to a international radio station outlet.
Mm-hmm.
And they give you online, they give you a globe, and then you can turn the globe with your cursor, and then you can just pinpoint a little dot on the map that is a dot, and there you will get that radio station streamed to you. It really is cool, and I'm from the old school. I love my radio. Good morning, Wanda, Loretta, Tammy, Sylvie,
Mary
Ligoritz,
Debbie, Juliet, Cynthia, Donna, Suzanne, Roxy, everybody's here, Teresa, Kathleen, Juliet, Kathy, Patricia, Elaine, good morning, Elaine, Jennifer, minus 36.
Sylvie. Lorraine is here. Lorraine is also here.
Good morning, Lorraine.
You must be up early.
Yeah, or not gone to bed yet.
Exactly. Brenda, Patricia, Kathleen, 28 degrees. Tammy, goodness. Gail, Stetler, Cynthia, Tenny, Juliet's back, snowed in. Gee, all you can do is stitch.
Yeah.
Exactly. We're really sad about it. Linda, Carol, hi girls, we're cold there too. Polar vortex, exactly. There's something about a lobe too, a temperature lobe that I heard about. Okay, what are they going to come up with next? Anyway, welcome to you all for Stitch Along Friday. We're very thrilled that you're here.
Absolutely.
I'm thrilled you're here too.
Yeah, I'm thrilled I'm here too.
The cool thing about our snowfall is it's not going to come until tonight.
That's right.
Which it's like the end of a week for us. So Lisa got to come in.
I did.
We got to do our little presentation to you guys. And then we're going to be snowed in until Monday, which is Family Day. And
Absolutely.
Then on Family Day, it's going to start to rain and go up to 5 degrees, which is like above zero.
So I'll be back in on Tuesday again. It works perfectly. If we're going to get a snowstorm, that's the perfect time when I'm home.
No traveling.
That's right.
Oh, good. Lorraine, that's good. Paulette, cold here in Ottawa, too. Exactly. Well, we're cold across all of North America.
Yeah.
I think Lorraine and other Joy Straw, if she's here, many other people from Australia, New Zealand, I don't think you guys have the same temperatures.
No, definitely not. Lorraine's probably got her air conditioning on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was a fire near Perth last week, so we're very happy that they figured out how to fix that.
Absolutely.
Karen Peterson is here. Patricia says it's colder in the UK where my guy lives than where I am right now. It is still exactly. And Mary's, it's cold. Lorraine, is no snow here, but we'll be plus 33 centimeters.
We don't get that on our hottest days.
Send it up here. That's all I can say. So nice to hear that you're, you know, cozy and warm down there.
Cozy. Yeah, I'd say that's way warm.
And in Florida, it's also warm and sunny. That's really good. Well, we have a celebration of sorts with our red on.
Yes,
and we have our Chinese New Year. And by the way, did you know in Victoria is the oldest Chinese community in Canada?
Yes.
You did know that?
Yes, I did.
See, exactly. I can't tell Lisa very much.
I think it's also the second oldest Chinese community in the North America.
That wouldn't surprise me.
I think San Francisco and then Victoria.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And because, you know, we brought people out here, I suppose.
That's
or
right.
Somebody did. Yeah. I didn't. I honestly didn't do it.
You wouldn't think that it would have been Vancouver, though.
I would have thought
that. Than Victoria.
But many people, I think, came to Victoria because it's much nicer here.
Oh, true. That it is. Very true.
I have no idea. I would have thought that, too. Good morning, Amber. Yay, you made it. Good for you. Donovan Buxel is here. She's got the snow. Pat says, trying to stay warm. Good morning from Rainy Atlanta. Every one of us in the Northern Hemisphere wants things to get warmer.
That's
now.
Right.
Brr. Even I have my sweater on today.
I know. And that's so unusual for you. So it's like, I'm not taking the sweater off today.
So to those of you who have just arrived, I practiced this morning.
Oh, did
and
you?
I hope it's okay.
Yep.
If anyone who speaks Chinese says it's not okay, I understand. Okay, ready? Gong, qi, fai, choy. That's good, right? With a little lithium.
It sounds good, but who knows? You could be swearing for all I know.
That's true. And when you speak another language badly, it's really funny to people who speak the language.
Oh, that's right, exactly. You might not have the right connotations to it, right? It could. Yeah.
That's right. Ooh. Yeah. Especially the lilts in your voice has
absolutely.
A lot to do with it. So hopefully. And Carol says there's 47 of you there.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Carol. And how exciting to see so many of you come on board again. Pat's got snow coming Monday. Loretta's got hers. Oh, ice. Ugh.
Yeah.
No, that's no fun. And it looks like there's cold snow coming Monday in Texas. Wow. Happy Chinese New Year to everyone. Wishing everyone a prosperous and healthy one.
Yes.
Thank you, Jennifer Chung. Did I say that okay?
Yeah.
I mean, I know it's not perfect, but just tell me if, you know, you recognize what I said. And also, of course, happy Valentine's Day to everyone. You know, I was wondering if you had an idea of what to do on Valentine's Day during COVID. Like, we're all meant to stay in, so we can't go out to our traditional restaurants. What are you planning on doing?
I plan to do very little
today.
Yeah,
that's Sunday.
Sunday.
So you must have some kind of tradition.
No, sorry, neither one of us are romantic people. So you know,
you didn't set up things like tricky little presents hidden under the pillow or anything like that.
Absolutely not. I kind of start telling them a few days beforehand that it's Valentine's coming.
So, okay.
And
so
I
you
like
have to
chocolates.
Let them know.
And I tell them where to go. And even yesterday I said, just to let you know, Sunday is Valentine's Day. We're supposed to get snow, so you might want to go tomorrow.
This is not secret. And does he still, like, maybe not do it?
No. He'll go and get
chocolate. What about you giving something to him? That doesn't happen at all?
Well, see, I tend to buy him treats all the time, so I figure that's
you do it all year, the rest of the year.
Yeah, okay. Exactly, yes.
So what about you guys? Have you got any special things planned? I went to my nail tech not too long ago, like last week, and she said that she and her husband love salmon, so they're going to go out and get a salmon and they're going to cook it in their apartment. And I said, that's it? That's all you're going to do is eat? And she said, well, yeah, what else is there to do? And I'm thinking, okay, you guys must have something, like an exchange of gifts or cards or something handmade, like, you know, you knit them a red scarf or something. If anybody's got any ideas, that'd be cool. Okay, so Jennifer Chung says, happy Chinese New Year. And hopefully you'll answer me in saying that I did say it reasonably well. Looks like you got yourself a second COVID-19 shot. Well, good for you. I'm afraid Canada is way behind.
Oh,
one of the last ones in the first world Here is Canada.
Yeah.
I have no idea. Some bureaucracy. I think it has something to do with...
Someone didn't put the order in time.
It's either that, or I think this is more like it. There are so many agencies that have to approve things that, you know, it goes through the chain of command like way slow.
Yes. Yeah. Well, yes. But
our bureaucracy is not great. So anyway, I'm really glad that the U.S. is ramping up now that Biden's really on everyone's case and getting everything done so quickly. So we're really thrilled because that'll mean there'll be better relations between the U.S. and Canada. Maybe the border will open up sooner than later.
Absolutely, yeah.
Which is great for us because we not only miss you guys, but it feels awful to be all isolated up here without any, you know, across the border traffic.
Yes.
We get a lot of Americans
here
in Victoria.
Absolutely.
So let's hope you guys do a great job. And, oh, Lorraine says, very subtle, Lisa.
No, I could actually drive them to the store. That would be the other option, but, you know.
Oh, that's funny. Oh, that's really cute. Amber says, husband and I are going to do a virtual wine tasting at home. There's a good...
That's a nice idea.
Perfect. And then do you also get drunk? Or is it just...
just a little tasting.
Because so. Wine tasting is something different, I understand. You have to slurp it.
Yeah.
I suppose you'll only be tasting red wine because, you know, it's Valentine's.
Valentine's Day, yes.
Debbie says, no plans, recovering from COVID. Oh, well done. I'm so glad you're recovering, Debbie. Oh, good for you. I'm so glad that your husband has been taking good care of you. Excellent. It's really good to hear about recoveries. Jill says, good morning. Valentine's Day is my husband's birthday, so we'll cook him steak and crab and angel food cake with huckleberry sauce. Doesn't that sound good?
Yes, it does.
I don't know what huckleberry sauce tastes like, but it sounds good.
Huckleberries are good.
Yeah. Oh, good. Jennifer says, yes, I understood what you say. Gong hai fa choy. Thank you. We never did anything special for Valentine's Day. Now, most people, I think, if you've been with the guy longer than a couple of years.
Yes.
Or with the girl, sorry.
And even if, you know, the first couple of years, I don't think we really got into Valentine's Day. It's just,
sometimes you think to yourself, who's actually profiting from all these days?
Oh, that's right, exactly.
It's probably more like the companies that are setting it
all up. Oh, that's right. And I'm not big on large crowds anyway, so going out to a restaurant was never what I wanted to do on Valentine's Day. So.
Well, having spent a lot of these years alone at some point during my life, like 5 years I was on my own, I remember Valentine's Day as not feeling particularly left out or anything. Mm-hmm. I just really started to think about my friends.
Yeah.
Because it's not
Absolutely.
Just about your, you know, partner.
Partner, yes.
It is also about friends. And you know who it was? My former mother-in-law, who has passed away since, used to give us and the children all Valentine's Day cards. Like, for her, it was the best way to express her love for us. Mm-hmm. And I thought, well, you can always send one to your mom, or you can phone somebody up that you love and, you know, share the love, which it doesn't have to be just your husband or partner of any sort.
Absolutely. I just want to say that right now we're really windy outside, so if the streaming dies or stops, it's because we've lost power.
Exactly. Yeah. It can happen. And I don't think we have a UPS on, in other words, universal power supply.
Yeah.
I don't think we have that on this computer.
No, exactly.
So that was a good thing for you
to
say.
I just wanted to say that because I heard the wind pick up out there. So
yeah, we've got quite a bit of wind, but we've had it pretty much all night. And I checked and I saw there was no power outages so far.
Which is surprising.
I know.
Yeah.
We're doing really well so far. So okay.
Fingers crossed. Even yesterday, I thought no flickering or anything like that. It was so unusual. But anyways, that's...
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So if that happens, just so you know, I will, of course, put the Stitch Along third part up. Just, I haven't forgotten. And I'll send out a notification with regard to our sale for this weekend.
That's right.
Okay, that's the business part. Okay, I usually bake my sweetie a sweet treat for B-Day.
Birthday?
Mary says, so that's your birthday? Okay, so that's different.
Yeah.
Nevertheless, baking sweet treats is a thing to do on Valentine's Day.
It is, but I'm not a baker.
No, you don't have to be a baker. Yeah. You just mix the cookie dough and put it on the sheets and stick it in the oven.
It just seems way too much work.
Way too much. I'd rather be stitching?
I'd rather be stitching. I'd rather go to a store and buy already made stuff. So
I guess you could do that. That's a way
if
to celebrate.
If it's snowing, no, I can't.
No, today, on your way home.
I could.
I mean, take a leaf out of the things you're telling your husband.
Very true, very true. I could do that, and I am planning on leaving early, so I could actually hit a store on my way home.
Jennifer Gowan says, years ago, I made my husband hearts out of snow while he was at work.
Aww.
Were they like snowball hearts? Were they the kind you throw at him? That is so cute. Tanya says, I'll celebrate Sunday evening, Valentine's and retirement.
Yay.
Oh, wow. Tanya, you must be in heaven. 40 years of nursing. Congratulations on your retirement. That is going to be a heck of a celebration. Okay. Really enjoy it. This makes me laugh so hard. You guys would love sitting in on coffee with myself and my seven sisters. We laugh so hard that tears run down our faces. We do kind of like to laugh a lot.
We do, yeah.
Anything that makes us happy.
That's right. Pat, I think that's a brilliant idea.
I buy myself flowers and chocolate. And you know what? I did buy myself some flowers also.
Yep.
Nice red ones. See the azaleas behind
me? Oh, very nice.
Yeah, they're just starting to bud. Uh-huh. I'm so thrilled with it. It's a plant that lasts forever in my kitchen. So, Carol, thank you, and invite us sometime. We'd be happy. Thanks, Mary Woodruff, 53 of you. Donna says Valentine's Day is another holiday that is ignored around my house. Donna, you have to train your house people, the people that you're living with. You have to train them. Do what Lisa does.
That's right, exactly.
Tell them.
Yeah.
You can't expect them to read your mind that you want something special.
No, exactly. And, you know, go out and get it yourself. So that's
a really good idea, actually. I remember years ago, my kids would never recognize my birthday or else they'd, you know, have spent all their allowance on themselves rather than me. So they'd pencil in something. And then I'd buy myself two little plants that represented their love for me.
Yeah.
I put them on my windowsill and think, okay, well, they do love me.
Yeah.
They just don't have any money. Of course, I gave them all sorts of excuses. But anyway, it's a way. It's a way. Oh, it looks like Carol is also a retired RN. Good morning, all, says Karen Krause. I can't wait to come to Vancouver Island from Oregon. I miss seeing my Canadian neighbors.
Yes.
Me too.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, we are still considering our virtual retreat.
Yes, we are.
The difficulty for me is that I have to actually stop what I'm doing and learn about Zoom and make sure that I get that right. Because if it's a paid retreat, which it has to be for us, then I have to make sure that I know how to do that, make sure that everyone's
absolutely,
in.
Absolutely, that the streaming will work properly.
Exactly. Yeah. So I have to still do a little bit of experimenting. Yeah. I've got the Zoom lessons all lined up for me.
Good.
After I finish doing the Beyond Cross Stitch for the Academy, because I'm almost done.
I know she's been a little manic this week. So, yeah.
I have done all of level 6 now as far as shooting them is concerned. Now I have to edit the last one.
Yes.
And then I have to put it up on the learning platform, and then I have to connect it to our Shopify website, and then everyone can take a class, and then maybe nobody will show up. That can
happen. You never know.
That's true. And Patricia says, Lindt chocolate is my go-to. Husband says they are in the house.
Yeah.
Can you smell them?
Yeah. Lindt chocolate's good. Yes. I you know, if I can't make it to the chocolate stores that I like to visit, I'll buy Lindt. But
Lisa has, I think it's like two at least chocolate stores, right?
Yes.
Places.
Yes.
Is the one up here in the mountain or not in the mountain on the hillside? Is that still one?
They don't do chocolates anymore.
Okay.
No, they don't.
She knows.
But I go to Bernard Calabot, which is Belgian chocolate. They're absolutely delicious. And then Purdy's, which has been around for years.
Downtown Victoria.
Yeah, and found in Victoria. The other one I like, which is actually a Victorian company, is Rogers. And I have just started eating Rogers as well. So, yeah.
Ask anything about chocolate to Lisa. She
knows
it all.
I'm a chocolate-holic. I love chocolate.
Yeah, and you like those strange flavored ones.
Exactly. I'm kind of a chocolate snob, too. So, you know.
Oh, that's funny. Tammy says she doesn't do much for Valentine's Day after being married for 26 years. Well, that's exactly what kind of happens
Absolutely.
To us all. But on the other hand, I thought this year with COVID, we might just get in there.
Well, that's right.
You
yes.
know, do something fun.
Exactly. I told my husband we have to watch a nice, happy movie rather than the war movies he likes to watch all the time.
That's a good idea. At least get a little bit of love
going.
Yeah,
that's right. Exactly. The other night we watched that 1917. It's like, oh, if we must. It's like, it was so depressing.
Loretta says, we don't have any special plan. Can't do much anyway because of COVID.
Yes.
I know you can't do. That's why I'm asking. If you've got any other suggestions than nothing, I mean, there must be something we can do.
Well, there must be. And I like Jean's. We ordered a complete dinner, including a bottle of wine.
From a local upscale restaurant for curbside pickup.
Cool.
Okay, that is a really good idea.
Absolutely.
Unless you can't get out. In which case, sometimes they have these food delivery companies that do a really good job.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, that all costs money. So another thing you could do is stitch a heart and give it to them.
Yes, absolutely.
That's one thing you could do for sure. I think we don't have any hearts here, do we?
No, we don't have any hearts
out
today.
We're looking for flowers and things now. Hello to all and happy Valentine's Day to all. I'm making my homemade bread for my hubby.
Oh, very nice.
That must smell just heavenly. Ah, un saluto especial desde Colombia, Jeanette. Thank you.
Yep.
I have been by myself for close to 25 years. Good for you. I think being independent is a really good way to live. Cynthia says there's 60 of us here.
Yay.
Wow. He's just getting a card. Nothing else, says June.
I don't even do cards. Yeah.
No, but cards you can make yourself are a different thing entirely.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can go out and buy one and then give it. I don't know. Somehow I don't like that anymore. I used to do cards, but not so much anymore. I don't know why. I think somehow that the card companies have really
monopolized on that. What they charge for them is huge.
I know. And you buy $5 and often, I hate to say this, but men in general are not that interested in cards.
No.
Sorry.
No,
unless they're really funny.
Well, that's right. Exactly. There's usually no sentiment to it. So, you know.
I mean, there are some men who would probably appreciate it and love you for giving them a card. But I think they'd prefer the bread or the cookies.
Exactly. Or beer.
Or
you know.
In Colombia, says Jeanette, they don't celebrate it. So that's too bad. You could maybe create a new way to do it in Colombia, okay? So in Colombia, start Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
The same as cooking. I'd rather sew than cook.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And Jennifer Gowan says big hearts instead of snowman because we get so much snow.
Oh.
Okay, good. Big hearts instead of snowman. Gotcha. So they're like outside on your lawn. That is a really neat thing to do. Thank you, Carol. I'm hoping to do some stitching through the weekend and Monday. I just started the Easter egg hunt sampler. I need to prep fabrics for poinsettia gazebo sampler, stitching witches, and scary stitches.
My goodness, Tammy.
You really do love to stitch, I know, and your work is so beautiful. Gail says, I'm going around to my children's and my grandchildren's house and deliver their cards this year. I have hot chocolate bombs and chai bombs shaped in heart shapes for them. Now, that is a cool thing to do.
Absolutely.
You know, doesn't take that long if you've got the time and you're at home anyway. And just make a few little things like that, little heart-shaped anythings, and drop them off on Valentine's Day. You've got two more days, right?
Mm-hmm.
We don't, of course, because we've got snow coming.
Yes.
And we want to be snowed in so bad.
That's right. Exactly. I'm looking forward to sitting there tomorrow stitching and watching the snow drift down.
And Tanya loves the dark chocolate. Thanks, Sylvie. Rogers was delicious, as Loretta.
Yeah.
June Bull remembers all the chocolate things. Oh, that's so nice. Serena Dubé, you're here. Nice to see you. There are hearts on the stitch along. Exactly.
Yeah.
You're right. Oh, that's really good. So we do have a few things that we want to share with you.
Exactly. And this week's Stitch of the Week is the Japanese ribbon stitch.
Huh?
And it's quite a versatile stitch. It can be used on many different things.
Carry on.
Clothing.
You can read it all out. This is the kit that it's based on.
Absolutely.
And I'll show them this. Good.
And basically it's a straight stitch, but then it curls at the tip. So it can look like a petal and a leaf and so on and so on. And depending on where you pierce the ribbon determines how big of a fold you're going to get. So Also, it depending on the size of the ribbon that
this one. Yes.
You can, it looks different. So if you use a very narrow silk ribbon, you'll get a more like for a spider flower. But if you use a wider ribbon, you can use it for rose petals.
Mm-hmm. This so. Actually, this lovely little, what do you call this? A wall hanging, I guess?
That's right. Yes.
On Bellpool Hardware, yeah. Which Lisa made, I think, or was
yes.
Yvonne? I'm not
yes,
sure.
I did that one.
Lisa did this one. She put three of our models, the forget-me-not is the one that we're focused on today, and then the rosebuds and also the buttercups. In the buttercups, it's a different kind of stitch. But rosebuds and forget-me-nots really do have the Japanese silk ribbon mm-hmm. stitch in them.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you don't have to pull it through all the way. So you can make of these stitches whatever you want.
Absolutely.
And we do have some designs that have 7mm
we
ribbon
do,
in
exactly.
them. I don't know if we have them here.
No.
We're going to show you a few of them.
I think, yes.
And as you're looking, could you just decide which one you're going to show? Because I'm going to say that we do have a sale coming up this weekend.
We do, yes.
And the sale yes. is going to be all about learning how to work with silk ribbon. And this is for you also, Lorraine.
Yes, exactly.
Lorraine has told me many times that she has a hard time with silk ribbon. I understand. And the course is going to be on sale. So I wanted you to know this weekend, you can learn by following the course. Okay, that the course will be on sale, and so will all 10 of the silk ribbon oriented stitches that are in
cool.
level 2.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
Go and watch for that. You can actually just look at that in your email because it's going to say something like silk ribbon sale. I think that's what it's going to be called for the discount. So I'm going to send that out to you as soon as possible and also make a little note in our Facebook group. In this group, because I want the people, the new people who may not come to this Stitch Along Friday mm-hmm. live mm-hmm. stream, they may not know what we do with silk ribbon. So I'm going to make sure that there's a little post. I know it'll be kind of, you know, about our company, but it's important that they feel welcomed and that some of the stitches that they don't know yet about, that they also get an opportunity to know that you can learn with the Academy.
Yes,
so
absolutely.
I wanted to mention that.
And so here's another one that has some Japanese ribbon stitches on it. This is called Stitcher's Garden, and it's a really pretty little design. I'm going to...
I think you might have to get up to do this.
I know.
Hey, you're stretching, but you know, you can't actually get close enough. There we go.
There we go.
A little close. There we go.
A little close? A little further back?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
There we go. And there's some more silk ribbon there.
You can see the silk ribbon with
and
the multicolored
more.
Silk ribbon
exactly.
that we got. Love that multicolored silk ribbon.
So and that's
it's an overdyed and
it's so overdyed.
Beautiful colors.
Yes.
I just love it. And actually started the design with that in mind because
mm-hmm.
I love the colors in this one. I don't know if you noticed that you can see them all at the bottom here. And they really go with the overdyed silk floss that I was using as well. And there it is. In the corner here. Look at all those gorgeous colors. Oh, I love that.
Then we've got this one, which is called Mystic Needlework Smalls.
Oh, yes. I don't know if any of you remember this, but I think some of the people that I taught this back in Mystic in, I don't know when, 18 years ago?
Yes, something like that.
I came up with something that would help them learn about silk ribbon.
Silk ribbon,
So there was a little bit of silk ribbon in this entire thing. And it was done for Stitcher's Hideaway in 2007. Yep. Can you believe it? And that is actually, of course, Mystic or meant to be right by the river. And look at the little silk ribbon at the bottom. It is so adorable.
Yeah.
And then also see the little silk ribbon motif here. That is a silk ribbon rose, which is really fun and easy to do. And the little nautical themed things on either side. This little pocket is so cute.
Exactly. And then all the leaves, of course, are Japanese ribbon stitch. Oops, sorry.
Correct.
Do you want to hold those?
I'll hold one.
Okay.
You can hold some.
There we
and
go.
These go with it as well. There are some elements taken out of the main design little thing. And I think this is also a needle case. And, of course, a scissor fob.
Yes, it is a needle case. There we go.
And you scissor can put fob. Your name on the back, which I didn't do, but it could be done.
And this one has many little different pieces. It also has a bisque or nœud.
Oh, isn't that amazing?
It is.
You know why it's amazing? Because you made it that way. And look at this.
It's actually appliqued onto the base. So you use a different color linen
for the base.
Top.
Oh, yes, exactly.
From what the base is.
Yes, so I think the base, you made it out of
white
linen,
mm-hmm.
and then the top was made out of this
I think it's
Confederate gray with white as well. And so, and then it's appliqued on, so the actual thing is separate.
Yes.
And was just stitched on top of this blank base that you made. Mm-hmm. Beautiful finishing.
Thank you.
Just gorgeous.
And then, of course, there's also a scissor case to it. So that's got many different
multitudinous
pieces.
Things. It was great fun for the class.
It was actually, this was a really fun piece to stitch.
Exactly.
I have to say that.
Jennifer Chung says, have you tried C's chocolate from California? Guess what?
Yes,
we used to, definitely, every year we would have a holiday, the VS holiday.
And Dory.
And Dory Davis would come from Ohio, and she would bring a box of C's raspberry in dark chocolate. So yes, we love having her come every year.
Yes, she would pick it up in Seattle on the way over to Victoria for us. Raspberry creams, right, Dory?
Yeah, and she used to come all the time.
Yeah.
But of course, now she's living in Czechoslovakia or the Czech Republic for the time being, where she came from, or parents came from. And then when she comes back, hopefully, we're going to get some more C's chocolate.
Absolutely.
It's delicious. Happy Valentine's Day to all the latecomers. I can't really call you late, but you know, you arrived and when we were already going. So happy Valentine's Day to you, Joanna.
Absolutely.
Pandora is here. Pandora Gaines. Thank you, Lorraine. 65 is a wonderful number. I can't believe so many of you come and join us during our live thing. We love it.
So
what else do you have?
We have, this is called the Heart Etui.
Uh-huh.
And it is, let me see if I can open it up. Anyways, it is actually a needle. Can you open it up a little bit?
It's a needle book, kind of, right?
Needle book etui type of thing.
Yeah.
And I think I'm going to have to open up the front one, too. And let's see. Okay. So the front looks like this. And then you open it up. And you get the inside like that.
Yes, and this, of course, is a little elastic band that you can put things under.
Yeah, and then we've got some wool felt over here.
There's even some needles in there.
Some needles. And then that is what the back looks like. Sorry.
Down.
Too close. There we go.
I know. Lisa can't see the monitor so well, so sometimes it kind of goes off the screen. Don't worry. It's beautiful the way it's shown.
And then, of course, it folds back up.
It does. And this part here, this is like the heart is divided, but on the back, it's not divided. And I've seen this stitched as a single piece that someone framed.
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful, just framed by itself this way. And of course, if you want to do these two, you can also do this one, this front one, by itself.
Absolutely.
Right? So that you just, or half a heart would be really good. And you give a friend of yours the other half.
Other half.
Wouldn't that be awesome? Yeah. Anyway, so these are also done with silk ribbon. And I wanted to show you the actual little leaves.
Bullion knots and then Japanese ribbon stitch leaves.
Exactly. And you can certainly see that the roses are bullion knots now that I've got it really close.
Yeah.
This is one of the most popular classes on our Victoria Sampler YouTube channel.
Mm-hmm.
This is the one we get the most comments on because it does cover just about every part of hardanger as well as silk ribbon.
Definitely.
So have a look at this because that is, of course, available for you anytime you want.
Yeah, and it also comes with Bisque Renew.
Same principle.
Same principle, except for this one is done on top of fabric rather
than
linen.
Doesn't that look cute? I love that.
Me too.
So that kind of lays on top.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice looking. I have to show. And then a little pink button in the middle. A pink heart button, it looks like.
Pink heart on one side, and I think the other side is blue.
Oh, and don't forget, there's always a tiny scissor fob, which is sometimes all you need to give someone
who's
your friend that stitches. They would love that.
Okay, and then the last one here, and we've got it both as a frame piece and as a pillow, is Sunflower Street.
Sunflower Street actually started out as a little sampler.
Yeah.
We have to move it over this way
a little bit.
Yeah, because otherwise you just see the sunflower fabric.
And then
other way.
Other way?
Yeah, no,
there?
It's in this side.
This side, sorry. I'm getting confused there. There you can see. Okay.
Yes.
The sunflowers are silk ribbon.
Yes, and they're also done with a Japanese silk ribbon stitch, believe it or not.
Yes.
You can see the sampler itself a little bit easier when it's framed. So I'm just going to show you the sunflowers really close up. Whoa, okay. I think I got it in focus and everything. I'll say. And then the sunflower little pattern is adorable and doesn't really take an awful lot long time to do. It's got many different scenes and some specialty stitches.
Yeah.
This is really good for someone who's a beginner and never done one of my samplers before.
Absolutely. It gives you a little bit of everything, except for Hardanger.
And that's sometimes really a relief to some new people.
Absolutely. But I love stitching these little samplers. They were very, very nice. You want to show this one, do you?
I brought this out because it's an older sampler, but it was years ago when I stitched it.
True.
And there is a little bit of silk ribbon in it as well. Isn't that silk ribbon
no,
right there?
No, it's not.
Oh, never mind then. You'll have to see it another time.
That's right. Exactly. We'll show that next time.
Okay. Here I thought I had a scoop.
Nope, you did not.
Okay, so
you want to start with the first one?
Yeah, I started doing my gazebos pretty much right at the beginning of
my career. Yes, yeah, yeah.
I started actually with the top of this one, which is called silk ribbon. Sorry, it's
silk
not
wisteria.
Called silk ribbon.
Called silk wisteria.
Called silk wisteria.
But it has silk ribbon on it.
Let's see how we can move
that. I'm going to move all this stuff out of your way.
Okay.
How about that?
So, thank you. So now I can sort of show the top, which is really cool. The desk is not so much in the way. Now these stitches are silk ribbon. A very easy and quick Japanese silk ribbon stitch. And then, of course, as you go down, you'll see all the various other stitches that are there. I started with the gazebo itself, just by itself. This is also silk ribbon, and so are these. And then it didn't go very well. People didn't just want to do this, so I created the sampler underneath it, and all of a sudden everybody wanted to do it. So I guess it's just a question of the meaningfulness of the words in it as well, because it says, kind hearts are the garden, kind hearts are the thoughts are the roots. Kind words are the blossoms, and kind deeds are the fruits. So I think that the meaning comes through really well in some of these gazebo roses, because they are also not just about gardens, but also about our inner gardens.
Yes.
A little bit of philosophy. I don't know if this one was the next one.
No,
I don't think
not.
It was.
No, that's the last one.
Is it? Okay, so then this one. Is this one next?
No. Sorry.
Lisa. She knows everything.
Nope. That's next.
Okay. So this one is called
Gazebo Roses. And the reason I say that one's next, because you were working on this when I first started working for you almost 24 years ago.
So that's how you know.
Yeah. So.
Well, that makes sense. I remember loving to work on this one.
Mm-hmm.
The shape of this one is a little bit Chinese oriented. It's like a little, literally like a little pagoda.
Pagoda,
gazebo.
Yes.
And then, of course, the words also. This is the kiss of the word, kiss of the sun for pardon, a song of the birds for mirth. One is nearer God's heart in the garden than anywhere else on earth. And the poem itself is very familiar, but it's amongst the garden atmosphere that I love those words. And then this one, right?
Yes.
Okay, got it right.
Yes. This is sweet pea gazebo.
These are the sweet peas.
Yeah.
And these are clematis flowers.
Exactly. And they're all done with Japanese ribbon stitch.
Correct. I'm holding it really steady so that you can see, because when you look at these and it keeps moving, it's much harder to look at. But the design itself, again, has a beautiful verse, all things bright and beautiful. I think you know this verse quite well. The clematis is echoed down below with more silk ribbon stitches, Japanese silk ribbon stitches. And then there's a bench. We showed this last week, actually.
We did.
But never mind. We like it.
We do.
And finally?
Silk bougainvillea. This is the one I have still left to do.
Silk bougainvillea?
I've done the other ones. They're all fun to stitch.
This one's going to be even more fun.
It will, once I get to it.
And this also has this Chinese pagoda-looking gazebo at the top. And look at that bargello, and yet more little flowers. And then this one is, of course, the verse is, Let's see if we can read the verse. To see the world in a grain of sand, Blake's poem, and heaven in a wildflower. Hold infinity in the palm of your hand and eternity in an hour. I think this is the most spiritual of all of the verses, but again, it goes with nature, which I love. So we do have another gazebo, but it's not here.
Nope.
It's called Christmas Gazebo. It is gorgeous, but it is at a needlework shop downtown.
Yes. So we'll have to go and collect it one time.
Exactly.
But it doesn't really fit with the other ones anyway.
No, it's very Christmassy and wintry and kind of like now.
We wanted to have something bright and sunny to stitch.
Exactly.
While we're under a snowstorm.
Yes, and also just to look forward to the spring.
Yeah.
I mean, it is just about spring. We know it is.
Absolutely.
Here especially.
It is. Yeah, I mean, our winter is February.
Mm-hmm.
And then March is spring.
Actually, we often have the, I think it's called the flower count or the spring flower count, which is in February, ends in February.
Yeah, that's right. It's the last week of February.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So,
but unfortunately, those little blossoms that have tried to come out in January, they're not going to make it.
Yeah, no, I'm worried about the daffodils in the field down the way.
Right?
If there's lots of snow, then bye-bye daffodils.
We'll make it through. Yeah. It's only momentary for us. Carol says, I haven't had a sweetie in nearly 30 years. Kind of like it. You girls are welcome here anytime. If we ever travel again, I miss all my Canadian friends. Thank you.
Yeah.
We'll have to make a trip.
Exactly.
Probably be a virtual trip. Yes. But still. Aw, that's really nice, Pat. Thank you. Karen says, snowing and snowed in here in Oregon.
Ooh, yay.
Oh, it sounds like... you said you're going to have a cozy weekend.
Yes.
So are we.
Yes.
And it's all going to be wonderful once we get started.
Yes.
Right? At the end of today, after work, we're going to go home and just get cozy.
That's right. Exactly. Yes. Yeah.
I got a brand new dressing gown.
I saw that. It's very cozy.
It's very cozy.
It's very cozy looking, I should say. I haven't tried it on. It's very cozy looking.
And I got a brand new dress and like a nightie underneath. I've never had a really long nightie with long sleeves because I'm more warm than cool. And so I'm really looking forward to breaking those in this weekend.
It'll be great not to, have to put on shoes to go outside this weekend.
Tanya says, what brand of ribbon on needlework is your favorite? Well, we have various different brands.
Yep,
we started out with YLI.
YLI, yeah.
Not so sure that we get that anymore.
No, we don't get that because their order requirements were too huge. So we now get it from a couple of different locations.
That's right. Actually, they're not really sold in regular stores, as far as I know.
Mm-hmm.
But we also get some from our favorite supplier, which is Gloriana.
Gloriana.
They
beautiful.
Exactly.
Yeah,
so those are the ones we love the most.
Treenway is also a really good
mm-hmm.
silk ribbon company.
Exactly.
And then Dinky Dyes is the other one.
They do that too.
Yeah.
That's right. Susan Robinson says, good morning. Are you ready for the snow? I have my stitching out and ready.
Yeah.
Nice to see you, Susan. Oh, the course sounds interesting. Kathy, it really is.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that you said that because the course itself takes you right from the beginning of silk ribbon and how to thread your needle, everything about silk ribbon. And so that you don't feel like you're like attempting something without some guidance.
Mm-hmm.
It's a wonderful way to go through all 10 of the Beyond Cross Stitch Silk Ribbon Level 2.
Exactly. And, one thing is to be a little more accepting of the silk ribbon because it's not going to be perfect.
No, it's...
meant not to be perfect.
Silk ribbon is very organic.
Yes.
And so,
it is.
Should absolutely accept what the silk ribbon does for you.
Yes, that's right. Exactly.
And I always pull silk ribbon through until I get sort of a little fold and then I stop.
That's right. Don't pull too much.
No, if you pull through, don't do that. Debbie says, I love this. That's so good. Thank you. And Jennifer Gowan, you made it to 70.
Yeah.
Thanks for checking on the numbers.
Thank you.
70 of you here at one time.
Awesome.
Is just... That's heartwarming.
It is indeed.
I love that silk ribbon flowers are placed in the hardanger.
Yes.
Thank you. Combining all the various different techniques to me is, especially if it's very subtly done and elegantly done, then you get the best of all these worlds.
That's right.
I mean, I would love to include things like Casal Guidi,
mm-hmm.
Reticella lace, but I have found that I can't really go too far into the different techniques.
Yes.
without good technique education.
That's right.
Because most people will say, nah, that's a little too much for me. But hardanger is pretty mainstream now.
Yeah,
so
it is.
So feel free to learn the hardanger when I finish the two levels of hardanger in the Beyond Cross Stitch in the Academy.
Yeah.
It's going to be heaven for people. You can really progress beautifully. Cheyenne says, oh my gosh, I made it to a live video for once. Cheyenne, you're here. Good for you. I see you all the time, and it's so nice to have you here live. That's great. And Tanya says, I did the Mystic Biscornu, which has silk ribbon.
Yes.
It does indeed. Lauren says, although I'm not a fan of the ribbon embroidery, I do have Mystic Needlework started. Well done. Must get back to it one of these years. Now, you know what? You have finished so many of previously started projects. I am so impressed with how many things you've finished.
Now is a good time to finish that one, Lorraine, because everything else is off your shelf.
Stitching Christmas Village on Chilly Friday. That's a great idea. And June has done that. Oh, it looks really nice. Oh, Dory is here. Yes, dark chocolate raspberry creams. Mm. They were my dad's favorites. The C's chocolate. The first time I bought them was right after my dad died. That is such a nice thing to do to remember him. Yeah. I hope you get some very soon again.
Absolutely. And just to let you know, Dory, I can't get C's up here, but Rogers does do have a raspberry cream. It's almost as good, but not quite.
It's a good thing you said that to Dory, because she might not bring them again.
That's right.
Suzanne Healy has actually already bought the Hardy Twee. I noticed.
Yeah.
Suzanne, I want to stitch it, you said. And I'm so glad, because we're going to send it to you as quickly as we can.
Absolutely. I've also seen the Hardy Twee done in different colors, and it looked fabulous.
Yeah, all sorts of different colors.
Absolutely.
Actually, I've seen it on a darker fabric.
On a darker? And I've seen it done with yellows.
Have you?
Yes.
Oh, I don't remember seeing that.
I saw it with yellows, and I thought, oh, that's just fabulous.
Personally love to see anything in different colors.
That's right.
Which is why we do the stitch along.
Definitely.
Dory says, I love doing the stitching on the Hardy Twee. Finishing is a bit labor intensive, but I'll get it put together someday.
Yeah, well, finishing is always a little bit labor intensive, so.
I think what you do is a really good way to do it. Do it in steps.
Absolutely.
So that you have like small wins along the way.
Yeah.
So if you say, I'm going to cut out all the cardboard, or what do you call it?
That's right.
Cardstock.
The mat board. Yes.
And then that's all you do.
That's right.
Cut all of that out and then that put it away again.
Yeah, exactly. I've had Valentine pincushion on my sewing table probably for about a month now. It's all in bits and pieces. I think I've got all the templates done. I've got some of the mat board cut. Anyways, and so every once in a while I'll go in there and get some inspiration. I don't really dive right into it.
And do it all. No, and those steps, I think, especially with the more complicated things. I mean, with the simple one simple thing to finish, it's not so bad.
That's right. Yeah.
But anyway, I love the way you do that, because you don't get tired of it. You're always got something on the go.
I've always got something on the go. So anyways, for Valentine's Day weekend, I'm going to be working on my Valentine pincushions. So.
Nice, eh? Very appropriate.
Absolutely.
And Bob just can come in and appreciate it, and that's his gift.
Well, he can, yes. Yeah, and actually, quite often he says, aren't you going in your sewing room? So I think he rather likes it when I go in my sewing room. It gives him some peace and quiet.
Peace and quiet to watch 1917.
They watch 1917, yes, or Conan the Barbarian, or, you know, one of those many, you know, let's watch something with a sword. It's like, oh, yay.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yeah.
Patty England is here. Yay, you jumped in on break. If you're still here, I'm so glad you jumped in. Aw, that's really cute.
I'm actually so thankful he never watches this, because he might think I'm terrible saying things about him.
Well,
I think we
do love our partners.
Yeah, absolutely.
But on the other hand, they're really great to make fun of.
They are really great to make fun of. That's right.
Loretta's got the sunflower piece in her stash. Great. I did silk wisteria too. Oh, that's really nice. And I think that you're looking at the sunflower one. I did the sunflower at Minneapolis Retreat. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's where I started it,
absolutely.
Diane. You're absolutely right. Sue, you're checking in from Connecticut. Yay, you're happy.
Yep.
You're here. How are you feeling? Hope your PT is working and that you're not too snowed in.
Yes.
I kind of missed you lately. Loretta says, stunning. Nice. Yes. I love the variegated silk ribbon of the Clematis. Oh, how I love Sweet Pea in my stash, in my stash. You have to bring it out. What type of ribbon is best for silk ribbon stitch? Silk ribbon is best.
Silk ribbon, yes.
And Jennifer McEwen, the reason I say it like that is because there's all sorts of ribbon on the market.
Yes.
And some of it is rayon, some of it is
satin.
Don't use any of the regular ribbon. Buy one of our ACK packs that we still have left.
Absolutely.
And by the way, we have to apologize. Our supply chain is not broken, but it is
slowed.
Yeah, slowed down.
Things are coming back, though.
Manufacturers are trying their best to get their supplies, say the raw silk ribbon, then they have to dye it. So it all takes time. So I wanted you guys to know we are on it.
Yes.
And as soon as we get any ACK packs made or that we have enough materials to make ACK packs, we immediately put it on our website. So that you know, if there is a ACK pack shown and it says it's out of stock, it will be back in stock soon as we get the materials.
That's it. Yes.
It's not easy during COVID, let me tell you.
It has been very interesting.
That's for sure. So anyway, silk ribbon. Okay. So buy one of the things that's going to be on sale this weekend is one of the gazebos or the gazebos.
All the gazebos.
So some of them, I think, or one of them maybe still has an ACK pack with it. I recommend you get an ACK pack so that you know what the silk ribbon actually feels like.
Exactly. Or any of the level 2 Beyond Cross Stitch kits.
Yeah.
Except for 203. I don't think that one has silk ribbon in it.
But if you buy all of them, I think there is a value pack.
Absolutely.
So you save quite a bit
on the
value pack.
Yes.
And then you might even save some more this weekend.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so also there's courses on the Academy for the silk ribbon too. So doing level 2 is a great introduction to doing silk ribbon.
It really is. And the course will be on sale this weekend, which is awesome. And so are the Beyond Cross Stitch value pack. All of these, there's 10 of them, and that's what the courses are based on. Lorraine says there's 73 of you now.
Yep. Yay.
Amazing. Thanks, Suzanne, too. Mercy says, hi, everyone, out running errands. Well, good for you, because that's very good exercise, running. Donovan Boxall says, the only garden I have is if I stitch one. The gazebos would be perfect. Oh, you did do the Christmas gazebo.
Yes.
How nice to hear. Thanks, Loretta. Cheyenne says, here in Oklahoma, we are supposed to be getting record snow and we'll be below zero for at least a week still. Yes, and that's kind of south from here.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know this, but we've got this blustery wind on our window here that's like, good thing we're wearing sweaters, I tell you.
Well, that's right. Actually, I can feel that draft through the window today. So
we're not really used to it.
Yeah, no.
It's sort of like Oklahoma, I'm sure. Joy says, minus 14 in Kelowna. Oh, my goodness.
Woo-hoo.
Burr is right.
Yeah.
Jennifer Gowan says, any news regarding the release date of your newest design? Thank you for asking. We are almost there. We just have to get it framed.
Absolutely.
And then we are still on the fence with regard to Zooming it for our a virtual retreat. So if we do that, we'll do that first and then we'll release it. So just so you know, we're kind of on the fence still because I don't know about Zoom.
Yes.
But it's very close. So thank you for asking. Really appreciate it, actually, because we're not forgetting about it.
No.
But it is something that does take time to go through the process, as you know. My first order from Victoria Savage just came through the mail slot. You're kidding. Right now? Okay, that's fortuitous.
Yeah.
That's really great. And Pandora's order arrived Wednesday. So our orders are getting to you guys in pretty good time these days,
absolutely.
I think. We have, we've set up, actually one of our staff had set up a pickup from Canada Post. So for us, it's been great because we don't have to take everything
that's
to the post office anymore.
Those
pickups, now we've accelerated the pickups, so we get them 3 times a week.
Yeah.
So we'll be having a pickup today sometime.
We will have a pickup today sometime.
Which is good, because then you'll get your parcels that much sooner.
Exactly. Except for anyone who's placing orders today, they won't go out until early next week.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Either Monday or Tuesday, depending on whether we have a long weekend.
Yes. This weekend will be Tuesday. So.
Yeah, we have Family Day weekend this weekend. I don't know how that's going to go with COVID. They're all going to be Zooming.
Let's hope they're Zooming and not gathering.
That's so true. Yeah. Lorraine says, one retreat project left to finish, and then I'll have done all of them.
Oh, yay.
Wow. and you attended a lot of retreats. I'm about to start on the last one, the Victorian purse, but guess why I stopped? Ribbon embroidery. You know, you had that Victorian purse out to show people.
You want me to get it?
You can definitely, by all means, get it, and I can put it on, but I didn't want you to show the pincushion, because the pincushion ribbon is just not looking good. It needs ironing and everything, and putting on nicer. The purse is here, and so is the little, what do you call that little thing?
The thimble
holder, but it's called, holder. Oh, bodkin? No.
Yeah.
No, pipkin.
Pipkin.
I love that name.
Exactly. Okay.
Serena says, for Valentine's, tell your sweetie you were given the perfect gift. The perfect gift is from Victoria Sackler, buying it yourself.
Love it, Serena.
That's the perfect gift. And don't forget, your sweetie can give you a gift card now.
Absolutely.
Remember,
we have gift cards.
And just look in the I think it's called the catalog, and at the bottom it shows gift card, and you can actually... Or he can actually buy one, then give you the link, and you use it that way. I'm not exactly sure, but the description and how to use it are in there.
Exactly. I haven't had anyone say they can't use it, so I'm hoping that...
We're hoping it's working.
It's working.
It's worked for one person already, didn't it?
I think so.
Yeah, but, from Christmas.
Yeah.
Anyway, so let us know if it doesn't work. And there are 77 people here.
Yay.
And then 73. And then 75.
Yay.
I mean, up and down.
Up
in
and
the
down.
70s.
In the 70s. Okay.
Wow. Okay. You wanted to show
Here's
something.
Victorian purse that Lorraine was talking about.
Exactly. And the silk ribbon is right here.
Right there.
At the bottom.
Both the loop stitch and then the Japanese ribbon stitch.
For the leaves.
Yeah. For the leaves.
The loop stitch is a little bit like the Japanese ribbon stitch, only the loop stitch, instead of going to the point at the end,
that's right,
piercing the ribbon at the end, you pierce it closer to the where it came up.
Exactly. That's and it. You leave it a loop.
You leave it looped.
Yeah.
Anyway, Lorraine, I know you can do this.
Yeah, that's right. Exactly, Lorraine.
Okay, and you're going to show the
I'm going to show
book.
The book.
I'm going to show the pipkin first. Come on, you guys. Pipkin opens up like that. That's got to be something. I think that putting your thimble in here is almost too bad. You got to put chocolates in there.
Yeah. Oh, that's a great idea.
It is.
Yeah, hide
and
some
the decoration has a silk ribbon rose. There we go. A silk ribbon rose and with the loop stitch.
Yes.
And then the bargello at the bottom.
That's right. Exactly. And then here's the needle book. And so the silk ribbon, Japanese ribbon stitch is all along there. And then... You got a little scissor case.
You know right what there? I liked about this one is the spine.
Like, me too.
This is the little thing that goes with it.
Yeah.
It's got two sides.
Oh, exactly.
Sorry. I got our hands in there.
There we go. One way.
Yeah, one way and the other way.
And then the other way.
A little bargello
there
heart.
There we go.
But this thing, this spine, even though it's a little wiggly,
it looks great. Yes. I think next time I would probably use like Skirtex to give it a little more body.
Yeah, it either should have that, or maybe it should be tied a little tighter or something.
A little
tighter.
I think I didn't put any mat board in it. So
maybe that's what it is.
I think that's what it is.
So the main thing we have it for is so that it has room for the scissors inside. Oops, for the scissors inside. Yes. And that way it can actually be closed carefully. Anyway, that is the Victorian ribbon. The Victorian purse.
Yeah.
With all its accessories, and that's what Lorraine's going to be working on. Brenda says, hi from Ontario. And Sue says, after 4 years, two surgeries, and months of physiotherapy, I can now walk up and down the stairs like a normal person.
Awesome.
Wonderful. I'm so glad to hear that your PT is starting to really pay off for you, because walking up and down the stairs like a normal person in a house with a staircase is kind of important.
Absolutely.
Like,
yes.
Well done. And good for Michael for seeing you through it all. This is not easy. Ah, it looks like Patty says it's minus 13 degrees in Denver. Ooh. Okay, some people are... Yes, silk ribbon sale. Exactly, Karen Peterson. There is a silk ribbon sale this weekend. Yay! Rhonda Polk says, morning, ladies. Enjoying the live. Thank you. And
3 inches of snow so far. Woo-hoo.
Ann Miller just ordered the Hardy Tweed.
Yay.
So glad.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping that you got the ACPAC to go with it. We're encouraging Lorraine to do it. Yay! Are we having a virtual retreat? I hope.
We're talking about it.
We are still talking about it. As I said earlier, you may not have heard, and we're really working hard to find out how to do it with Zoom and have it as a paid gathering. So
yes.
We want to be sure that we do it all correctly, and I haven't yet had time.
Yeah.
Really.
No. Tay's trying to finish off some other videos.
And I'm finishing off the classes
yes.
that are going to go in the academy, the last
mm-hmm.
three levels. The other thing is that I'm mainly the tech person here now that Petra's no longer working for us.
Mm-hmm.
So trying to figure out tech at 72 years old isn't easy, okay?
She can do it.
I can do it with some time.
Yeah.
Exactly. Shan says that she's talking to Tanya Kelly. This is nice. Very nice. Love the pimpkin. I do too.
Yeah.
Thanks, Kathy Bird. It's good to see you. I like that pattern. What's it called? Uh-oh, that pattern. You see, our problem is we see your comments quite a bit later because there's so many comments.
Mm-hmm.
So, Tanya, can you please, at the bottom now, the next person, can you please let us know which pattern? And I'll be sure to answer. What's it called? I wonder if it's the latest one that we've been doing.
I think it was probably the Victorian first.
I'm assuming
yeah.
it was. You should make a Valentine's Day mailbox, an envelope with some Valentine cards as a pattern. I really
yeah.
shouldn't, Patty. I love that. I don't know why I haven't done it already. Anyway, thank you for the suggestion. I always love suggestions. Yes, Victorian purse. Lorraine,
yeah.
That's good. So cute. Love the pipkin. The pipkin is adorable, and it's not hard to do either.
No, it's not.
Oh, my goodness, 78 of you at one time. I know that we've had more people
yeah.
actually over the time that we've been here.
Yes. Yeah.
But to have 78 at one time
is
I think it's
yeah.
almost, no, it's not quite a record.
No, I think you had the record and it was 90 that one time.
And that
so
was just me because
it was New Year's Day.
Exactly. That was exciting.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I couldn't believe how many people showed up. Is the purse pattern in your store? Yes. It's called Victorian Purse.
Yes.
And it's a good thing you showed it.
Absolutely.
Because people seem to be very happy with the pipkin.
That's right. Yes.
And the silk ribbon is easy peasy. And
absolutely.
If it's not easy, then take the course in the academy.
That's right.
Okay?
Yes.
Just go to the catalog in our website, and there it says course registration. You register there.
Yeah.
And the purse pattern is included in the finishing instructions. Thanks, Dory. Virtual is better than none. Thanks for looking into this.
Yeah.
You're welcome. And Germany's got 17 degrees.
And Patty, you're still over in Germany? I thought you were moving back to the States.
Sounds like it. Oh, Brenda, go look after your grandbaby and come and check in with us later for the thing. But thank you for joining us. That's wonderful. Yes, it's called Victorian Purse. Thank you so much. It got to 89 today? You're kidding. I have no idea, Debbie.
Yeah.
Thank you. I don't know whether that's 89 degrees. Or
no, I think it's 89 people. Yeah.
That would have been funny. Well, I think we've pretty much run through my entire list here.
I think so, yes.
Let's see. We got the models. I said Kong Chi Fai Chai. And that is my really bad pronunciation of Happy New Year
yes.
in Chinese. And, of course, Happy Valentine's Day to everyone. And I wonder if anybody wants to see the stitch along now.
Oh. I would assume so.
It's possible.
Yes.
Aw, love to all of you,
yeah.
too. Love to everyone. The weekend is calming with all the stitching going on. I have a feeling that it will be calming because
yes.
we're going to be snowed in.
That's right, exactly.
And Debbie said people.
Yes. That's what I thought.
It would have been very difficult if it had been degrees.
Oh, great, Patty. Okay.
This is so nice to hear. You're going to be living with Debbie. Excellent,
yeah.
excellent. Yes, because it's nice and warm there.
Yeah.
We'll hope to be moving by the end of 2022. Wonderful. Well, look, you guys, we would be able to talk forever.
We will, yes. And we've already gone way over our normal.
Over an hour?
Over an hour.
Oh, we've never done that before.
No.
Thank you all for hanging in
Absolutely.
With us.
Yeah.
So nice of you. I'm going to show you now the last part of February Stitch Along pattern, and it'll be up in a few minutes. It's not up yet, and then I'll send out a sale flyer as to what's on sale for our silk ribbon sale, the course, and some patterns. Okay, here we go. This is the way it looks. Finally, you get to see the sense of all of those white things that you keep seeing. I hope that you enjoy your February stitch along pattern and that you finish it all. I'm looking forward to seeing them. And a happy Valentine's Day to you all.
Yes.
And a happy family day to us.
Yes.
Because that's what's happening
in
BC. And
happy Valentine's Day too.
Thank you. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful weekend.
Yeah.
Thanks for all the hearts.
Yes. Exactly. Until next week.
Bye-bye.
Happy stitching.